plenty of people to do armchair quarterbacking, and hindsight's 2020. There'll be so many folks analyze this race or why folks thought we'd have different numbers than tonight. But does it matter now? It doesn't matter. So now I'm just trying to thank all of our supporters. I mean, there are folks in this room, folks I just hugged from Jackson County. He was my treasurer when I ran for the state senate, ran for lieutenant governor. I was with him this past Saturday in Altus. Those kind of people that are in this room right now. So I love them dearly, and they're great Oklahomans.
Do you have any regrets in the way you handled the campaign?
The regret is I wish we had more numbers than other people. You know, that's, when you don't win the football game, like, what's the regret? I wish we would have won a little bit. But, you know, I understand the question, and I've told people for weeks, I had a total peace in my soul. Not measuring the grapes, not overconfident, not cocky, but a real peace because of this. One, he's sovereign. You can talk about it when you're winning or think you're winning, but when you don't come, when you don't prevail, now you have to start living it. But also, I knew we couldn't work anymore. You know, in the last 7 days, I told some folks in Tulsa today at lunch, in the last 7 days, I think we had just over 20 communities across Oklahoma. Nobody outworked us, and that's no disrespect. You're like, we did something better than somebody else. That's not what I mean. Nobody outworked us. So the regret, you know, nobody's going to write a book about this campaign, but that'd be a chapter in a book, I guess, which you would do differently. It wouldn't be hard work.
You know what's next?
What's next? Immediate next is thank everybody who's in the room that I can, because I love these people. That's one of the great things about politics. I'm a relationship guy. I love people. I love our state. And I never got tired of answering questions. I never got tired of asking for thoughts or suggestions or advice from Oklahomans. So I'll do that tonight, but what's next? I'm excited about it in this respect. God loves all of us. He has every hair on our head number. And so if he didn't want me to be governor, obviously he did not. I don't know what's next, but it's got to be pretty neat and pretty special because I'm excited about this opportunity. So I don't know what's next, but I'm excited about it.
Did you continue to serve?
Well, you know, everybody knows Dad served in the state senate in the governor's cabinet. Mom served. She was on the tri-state board, the YMCA board. Mom served as a Sunday school teacher at our church. So I'm going to keep serving, either in my church or community somehow. But I'm not going to go in the garage tonight and stencil a new campaign poster. I'm not thinking about the next election. I'm not. I did not even have a desire to be reelected as governor. I just wanted to serve and put people first and try to make Oklahoma a better place.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you all for being here.